Good morning. I want to go over a few things with you guys on the walkthrough instrument that Ms. Clark and Mr. Kopp went over with you guys this summer at the retreat. I want to make sure everybody knows how to collect that data and how to use that, so when it is time for your walkthroughs and instructional rounds, you are good to go. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is open up your actual form from inside your drive. It should look similar to the screen that you see here. In order for you to share this with your support team, you're going to click the blue share button, send form. I like to check this box here so that way it's a short URL. You can right click and copy, or you can control C, that link right there, and you can email it to your instructional round support crew. What I typically like to do is also email myself, so that way you can pull that up on your iPad and I can give you a little tip on adding that to your iPad. Okay, once you have pulled that up on your iPad, I have it here on my phone, you should have the live Google form that looks similar to this. Now, if you're using an iPad, the easiest way to save time in the future when you're doing walkthroughs is to add this as an icon on your desktop. So this export button down here in the middle of your browser is going to be a nice little shortcut for you to add this to your home screen. So if you click add to home screen, you're going to have the options here to type in your title here. You can do instructional rounds or walkthrough, whatever you wanted to name that. Click add, and you're going to notice that down here on the bottom I have the form with just a click of a button. It's always going to be there ready for me. Okay, once you have completed that form, you're going to see down here 100% you made it, and then you're going to click send me a copy of my responses. This is going to email you a copy. Submit. We're going to go back over here to our form. Now, at this point, you should have an email that you can then forward to your teachers. And it's going to give them a summary of the walkthrough that you just completed. Now, in order for you to see your responses, you're going to actually go back to the inside of this form where you were editing. Up here in your toolbar, you're going to see responses. And then you're going to see two options, summary of responses and view responses. If you click view responses, it's going to open up a spreadsheet that's going to have a timestamp, who submitted the form, the teacher name, and all of the information that you just collected. The second option is to do summary of responses. This is going to be your pie charts. Depending on the questions that are in there, this is going to be where you can actually see a visual representation of the data that you collected. During Shelly's session this summer, she had you guys share a folder entitled Walkthroughs with your instructional support team. If you guys have already shared that folder with all of that information with that group of people, you won't have to follow this next step. However, it may be a good option to check. So you want to make sure that your support team has access to all of your data. So the easiest way to do that is going to be from inside of your form to click responses and then view responses. It's going to open up a spreadsheet. Okay, from this point, in order to access and to see that visual representation of your data, you're going to click on form, show summary of responses. This summary is going to be what you want to make sure that everybody has access to. So in order to do that, we're going to go back to the spreadsheet and we're going to click share. So if you have put this inside the folder that you shared with your support crew, you probably won't have to do this. But if it is already shared, you're going to see their names listed right below. If they have not, you're going to want to type their names in here and add them each to this document so that they can access your data.